Welcome to MarcusG.TV. I am Chef Marcus Giuliano, and I'm a chef on a mission. ChefOnAMission.com, ChefOnAMissionBlog.com. You can find a lot of my information. Or you go to MarcusG.TV, thus the intro, MarcusG.TV, like television. Let's see. Today is part of my series on the top 50 mistakes that restaurateurs make. I'm having a ton of fun doing these videos. I've made all these mistakes myself, and I've corrected them all, and I've learned from a lot of great marketers, and it's been a lot of, the whole process has been super fun. That's why I'm sharing this, these short little videos. I'm available to do much more in-depth consulting from these videos and the topics, and help you turn around your business and not work as hard and make more money and delegate and hire better employees. It's all part of the master plan here of being a restaurateur. So, number 28. We don't say no to the guests enough. And I know a lot of us have been taught, you never say no, you never say no. You know, there's just certain things that we cannot do. If you read Raving Fans, they tell you in the book, there's certain things we can't do, and we don't do it, and we won't do it, and here's why. Because this is our limitations. Know your limitations in your restaurant, and don't try to be everything to everyone. We do a lot at my restaurant, and we say something for everyone, and we do so much. But that's how we were founded, because we wanted vegans to be able to sit down with meat eaters and gluten-free people to be happy and dairy-free people to be happy and people that, you know, so we kind of merged. That's how we started out, by getting a bits of everything, all different ethnicities and different diet types, and blending them together so people could be happy sitting down. So that's part of our theme. I know we do personally way too much, but like I said, it's part of our core. It's part of our values. It's part of how we were founded. That's part of why people like us. But if you can't do something, if Thanksgiving's not your thing, or brunch isn't your thing, or catering weddings isn't your thing, because you don't have, I mean, we said no on weddings for the first like 3 years that we were open, because we just weren't sure we could handle it. Then we started small, and we realized we could do one, we could do another one. We went bigger, bigger, and bigger. So don't be afraid to say no, but please explain why you're saying no. And don't say no all the time, because there's a lot of things that the kitchen staff can easily do, can easily make. You know, I need tartar sauce for this fish. We don't have tartar sauce. How hard is it to make tartar sauce? Whip something up back there, guys. Okay? So this isn't a right or license to say no. It's a right to say no to the guests when you've exceeded what you normally can do as far as your capabilities, and explain it to them that that's, you know, for proper customer service, for this or that, it's hard for us to do that. And everybody, you know, some people say, I want this, I want that, right in the middle of a meal. And if you just can't do it, you say, you know what, I'll be happy to do it, but I need to put that towards the end, because what's going to happen is if I take the time to clear the board and do your special order, it's going to affect three or four tables. If we can get those three or four or five or six tables out of the way first, then I can devote 100% attention to your special order. The guests will be like, wow, 100% attention, that's great. I want to make sure you're getting what you want. Be honest, and obviously, don't be afraid to say no in the right situation. Thanks for watching. So I've been running my restaurant, Aroma Time, for 10 years in the Hudson Valley. And I used to be one of those restaurant owners that was married to my business, couldn't leave. The restaurant wouldn't be open if I wasn't here. I didn't trust anybody. I turned everything around. Been here 10 full years, like I've said. I've defeated all the odds. I opened up this fine dining restaurant, upscale restaurant, in a small, depressed community. I've learned a lot. I've made a lot of mistakes, and that's how I can confidently say, I can help you. I can switch that mindset. I can teach you tips and techniques that I've learned by doing it myself, and then masterminding with some of the top restaurateurs in the country and marketing geniuses. It's been a great 10-year run. I don't regret a single part of it. Now the thing is, I work on my business. I don't work my business, which is a totally different thing. I can teach you how to do that. It's so simple with the tips and tools and techniques. Owning a restaurant can be a lot of fun, and I want to show you how to have fun in your restaurant. So please, send me an email.